We are now in chapter 3, where we will discuss the fields of application of location data and technologies and how this can create value. Fields of application, they are very broad. We can think about traditional sectors where it's more obvious that location data and technologies are used. For ages, the military and security have used location data and technologies, for example, to simulate fight conditions. For example, US troops can't go in Russia to exercise, so they simulate that. So they use location data and technologies for doing that, but also more general, in a general way they use it. Another typical sector is in environment, in agriculture, in agro-environment, where a lot of data are used, location data, such as hydrography, soil data, land use, so a variety of data to simulate also, for example, in precision farming, how the farmer should adapt practices to optimize the production on the land. Another typical area is in tourism and cultural heritage. Of course, the mapping of points or locations to visit, or the typical tourist maps, but also in cultural heritage, location data and technologies is used since many years. And the fourth example of a traditional sector is in transport and mobility, where not only, of course, road networks, railway networks, air links, et cetera, are all mapped and monitored, but where you also use the location data and technologies to solve more complex mobility questions. For example, how can we avoid traffic jams by managing the road network in a better way? How can we intervene at crossings so that we have more fluent traffic? So these are typical traditional sectors. Also, real estate, facility management are other sectors where you can imagine location data and technologies are used. But there is much more. There are other sectors where it is used or more recently or maybe less intense. Insurance and banking, for example, we will come back on the insurance and banking sector. They might use it for finding the optimal location to have a new office of the bank, for example, but it can be also used for other aspects, as we will see in the case study later. Health, we have now seen with COVID-19, but also with other health challenges. Health sector has used it sometimes for monitoring clusters and finding relationships between the reason for a certain, for example, more cancers in a certain city area and, for example, the fact that close by there is a certain factory or a business that has an influence on health, etc. So it's maybe less used, but it is more and more used and there is more possible. Another sector where you might not imagine it immediately, but is education, where in certain schools, they use already location data and technologies to support in biology, in geography and other classes, this type of data and technology. So it's maybe at first sight not so obvious, but it is used more and more. And by using it more, by using location data technologies, not only in the traditional sectors, you can create value. The value is only created, the benefits are only coming when the data and the technologies are used in different business domains, as demonstrated in the previous slide, by integrating them in other applications or in existing applications. There has been a study in the Netherlands, a very interesting one, trying to quantify not only the direct value, but also the indirect value and the impact in terms of in monetary terms. So not only looking in the blue pillar that you see at the left side in the picture, location industry on its own, so because you have companies doing but location data and technologies, but also looking in how the location data technologies and applications and other outcomes are then used by the broader economy. And that has an impact there for it creates a new market. It creates also export possibilities, but also government is taking measures to use it and to integrate it in their daily life. And we will see that in other modules, the location enablement of a digital government is a key facilitator of creating this value. And then you can also look into the broader impact, of course, that's the orange, the right pillar on society. You can have benefits for the broader society, for citizens at large, for the consumer, but also it can generate new indirect impacts such as new employment because you have or you embed location data and technologies in different settings, in different new applications. So the benefits can vary. It allows to take data-driven decisions based on this where and why things happen. It facilitates the also the mechanism and the technology facilitate data integration and connection of different data types. It enables also to see complex questions and run sophisticated simulations and models to have answers on these more complex and combined questions, which would otherwise not be possible. And it allows also to ease communication through these intuitive representations, whether that's the typical maps or 3D or even dynamic mapping. This allows to not to be expert, but rather be a user consumer of this type of information. So it serves multiple business areas through many applications, but the key is that it is used and reused on many occasions. But there are also not only the obvious benefits, and also you can wonder what is the economic value. For example, you can create economic value for a business. You can do that and use location data and technologies for that. For example, by optimizing the location of a new business. So looking into the statistical data about the neighborhood, et cetera, et cetera. A lot of information coming together, and that might bring you really economic value. But it's clear that it's not only about the economic benefits and value, but also about indirect benefits and value. For example, by providing all this information towards citizens, towards businesses, integrate a lot of different sources of information, you can become more transparent as a government. You can be more open to citizens and share data and information through portals, but also through particular applications. And of course, by doing so, you will stimulate maybe exchange of information, and you might even be allowed to facilitate knowledge transfer, discussion, inclusion, and integration of, for example, citizen decision-making processes. So the location data and technologies allow to do this. So we do not speak on benefits in terms of economic value, but also other more individual and societal broader benefits. So what we have learned in this chapter is that location data and technologies are and can be used in many different sectors. You might think about the traditional ones like transport and mobility, but also less obvious ones like in health, etc. So almost any sector can be covered and can benefit from location data and technologies. And it is through the usage of the data and the technologies in particular settings, in particular applications, that value is generated and created, and it generates benefits for citizens, businesses, governments alike. And with that, our third chapter comes to an end.